Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. As you can see right here, it's a little chipping piece of wood. Here's the old coil form. I don't know if it's all in focus there or not. But anyway, it kind of split up and broke up. And if you look, all the little black spots right here, these are the spots of glue. They kind of sprayed it sparsely. It fell apart. So basically, I've not had it with this. See you later. What I do have is right over here another piece of poplar wood, and I planed it down to 15/32nds, which is basically the thickness of plywood. Due to finishing, they take off pretty much a 16th of an inch on plywood, so a half inch plywood is 15/32nds. There we go, 15/32nds. Get it down and nice and level. I took my belt sander with these clamped here, and I laid her down, and I could feel the edges, and I can feel where I'm close and where I'm not. I wore down into this one a little bit. My main thing was to get it level. That's the main purpose. Well, I've got a 5/16 drill bit right here, and basically I drilled a hole in here, and I drilled a hole here, and I drilled a hole here, and here and here. You notice the shape of the coil form on the inside that I used to have. These came out pretty good. These are supposed to be in the corners so that when you go to take your coil off, you have put a pin through both sides of your coil winder as you wind it up, and basically when you pull the pins, your coil should come loose of the form pretty easy. Well, seeing as the other part of the coil winder I said bye-bye with, might as well say bye-bye with these. These ones here, as you can see, were pretty much just enough at 4 inches. I decided to make some that were 4.5 inches, drilling a hole like Dan Rojas, and I pulled a Dan Rojas and cut my coil forms right here on the table saw out of some squares from wood that square. The little pieces flew off, so I'd suggest making them a little bit bigger so the corners don't fly off and hit you. But anyway, if you want to see somebody do that real good, go to Green Power Science and you can watch Dan Rojas do it. He's a pro at it. It's where I learned it. Now I cut some graph paper, 2 inches long by 1 inch wide, and the third square up. I took it over to half and half here. I'm going to drill some holes here and here and here and here to where it just barely comes out the end, and that's going to be basically the shape of my coil form again, just like here, which didn't come out so good. Glad to scrap that. It means I'm going to take part three down, and this will probably come up as part three. I decided to make three of these, as you can see these, and I just super glued them down, and that gives me a place to have something the same and original all the way across for everything I'm going to be making here. Anyway, I'll be back with you in a few minutes. I'm going to go ahead and glue these down. Okay, hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. Well, you've seen this and you've seen what I've done here. And anyway, one thing I wanted to show you is this stainless steel rod here, highly polished. As you can see, ground one side down with the angle grinder. Did it again and did it again, so I know I can cut it, plus I hammered on it. Here's what this was for. I'll show you the full length by moving across here. Quite a bit here. If you notice right here, I sharpened the edge like this, and then I ground into it from the side with the angle grinder to give it a sharp edge. I used this as a drill bit when installing my flue for my wood stove this winter. Seeing as I didn't feel like climbing up into the attic, I put this long sucker on the end of the drill, and drilled it. I stood on the wood stove. Here we go. Well, I was doing a video. Heard a bunch of sirens, and a helicopter landed just over there. Probably taking me vacuuming somebody to a hospital or something. Sounds like he's fixing to take off again. Looks like about 3 country blocks from us. Smelt smoke earlier and a bunch of sirens, and I just heard a bunch of sirens all over again. Well, come on, where are you hiding? Doesn't look like he's taken off yet. Thought he was about to. Anyway, I'll resume this video as soon as this helicopter leaves. It's just too loud when it gets over me. Let's find out where he pops up over there. Fix the takeoff. Let me zoom in. Well, there he is. Just came up. And they're right at about 15 minutes. Don't know what it's all about, but anyway, hope whoever it is safe and doing well. Okay, now that the helicopter's gone, notice that in line with this, I went ahead and made sure it was straight over the blade in the hole and clamped it down and raised the blade up slowly while it was spinning. And then I took her off. Sorry, I can't do all that on camera. I'm trying not to waste a bunch of time. But anyway, there's the next step. All right, the next step is to get your drill press set up. I'm looking straight down the middle of this line in the middle of this drill bit, and I'm looking straight down the middle of this line on the graph paper for the drill bit, so I know I'm centered. Raise it up just a bit.
Come down slow. That's it, right there. Good thing. Now I'm going to do the same for this one. Line it up.
Very good. A little bit of paper popped up and push that right through. There's the hole and you can see it is dead center. There we go. Looks a little better. Now I've got two pieces with the hole dead center and one piece with that there. We're going to put the form between it and the corners of this. I'll probably get them, put them together and do it all at one time. I have to drill this center hole here. Let me line that up. And that'll go there. Once I get the pin through, keep it straight, put the other one on too. I'll probably screw these together and drill all the holes in the corners. Then I'll see what I got left after I take it apart, and I'll go ahead and grind off the rest of this shape, and I shouldn't have any more problems.